Hello, my name is Melissa, and I am a medical student here at BU, and I'm going to be talking about how to use Papyrus, which is a note-taking program that's designed to be used basically exactly like you're using a pen and paper. It's available for Android, Windows Phone, Kindle, and the app itself is free. And there are a couple of add-ons that you can get for just a couple of dollars each that will make your using experience a little bit easier. There's only one add-on that I'd say is absolutely necessary, and that's the one that allows you to edit PDFs, which is pretty useful for the uses that I'm going to be talking about now. So this is particularly important for the paperless curriculum that BU is rolling out now, because personally I used to be exclusively a notebook and pencil note taker, and ever since I started using this program on my tablet, it's revolutionized the way that I study, and even if I had the choice to go back to pen and paper, I wouldn't. This is so much easier, more efficient, and basically, you know, helps organize your studying. So first, I'm going to be showing you how to make a basic note. So this is just exactly like as if you were writing on a plain piece of notebook paper. So I'm going to move over to the little plus sign here, and you can click on the little thing that says note. And then I'll bring up this basically like a college ruled paper. And so you can come up to this corner here and you can name your note. So I'm just going to be super basic about it. Call it note. And then just like, you know, most other tablet optimized programs, you can use pinch to zoom. So you can use two fingers to zoom in and out. You can also, if you put down two fingers on the screen and move them together, you can pan. And then also at the top of the screen you have your toolbar. So first of all, you can click on the little pencil icon, and it shows you that you can change the thickness of your pencil. I usually like to keep it around 1 millimeter. And then if you move to this box up here, you can change the color. So you can see there's a wide variety of lovely colors to choose from. You can also go to the customizable color selection tool. I'm just going to choose plain old black for now. So now I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. And the tablet that I'm using is the Galaxy Note, which has an integrated stylus. So it's particularly easy to write with this. So I can just write out a note, and this is basically my handwriting. It's, you know, very sensitive and essentially like you were just writing on a piece of paper. What's also really cool about this particular tablet and stylus is that you can make it pressure sensitive. So I can start drawing a line, and then if I press down harder on the screen with my stylus, then it will thicken the line. And also, what I can do is use the stylus to write, but then I can use my finger to erase. So that makes it easy, because then you don't have to keep on switching between, go over here, and there is an eraser tool, and you can use that if you so desire, but it's much easier to just be able to use your finger to erase. Also, you can click on this little button here, And that creates a highlighter. And this is very useful because it's a free form tool. It's not snap to line or anything, which makes it very easy if you're trying to highlight in a document. And again, you can just draw with the stylus and then erase with the finger. And then additionally, you can have your undo button up here. And then up here, it shows you in the top right corner what page you're on. And I can click on this little arrow with the plus sign to add a page onto my note. So now I'm on page two. I can click on this back arrow and go back to page one. And you can click on the little number, and it gives you a little jump to page screen, so you can go and select the second page. What you can also do, if you decide that you want to delete a page, is you can press and hold on the number. You can select delete page right here. And yes, I want to delete, and now it just goes back to having a single page on the note. And so then, what's really cool about this is that you can connect all of your notes to the cloud. So you can click on this little three dots in the corner, hit the export button, and now I can choose to export my note or just this single page in multiple formats. Hit share, and then you can see I have all of these selections of different cloud-based programs that I can use to save my note to. So let's say that I have my Dropbox account. I can click Add to Dropbox. I want to add it to my Boston University Medical School folder. Hit Add. And suddenly I have my wonderful little red squiggle saved as a PDF in my Dropbox account. And this is really easy because then you can annotate your notes on your tablet and then be able to access them basically from anywhere where you have internet access. So next, I'm going to demonstrate what I think is the most useful way to take notes for classes. So what I'm going to do now is go up to this little menu bar at the top left corner. I'm going to add a notebook, and let's say that I'm doing histology. Okay. Now my histology folder is empty because I just created it, but let's say that I'm doing respiratory histology for tomorrow's class, and I can go online on my computer or on my tablet and download a PDF of the syllabus. So in this case, let's say that I downloaded it from my computer and put it into Dropbox. So I can hit that. And then I see that I have my syllabus right here. I can click on that, open it up, and now I have the entire syllabus section that I can now click through. I can zoom in and out. And let's see, I can choose to zoom in a little bit here. And what I like to do is download the syllabus maybe the night before the lecture. Go through and just do a quick pre-read, not necessarily super in-depth because you're going to be learning all of this stuff in class the next day. But I can see that, let's see, the foregut is important, I suppose, and it gives rise to these different things. So you can be one of those people who walks around with a pencil case full of 12 different color highlighters and pens, or you can just come into Papyrus and automatically be able to switch up your colors with a touch of a button. And that just makes life infinitely easier. So what I can also do, once I've finished my highlighting, maybe I have a question here. Let's say I'm a little confused. What is the foregut? Make a little note to myself in the syllabus. Come back to that later. All right. And now, let's say that we're coming into class for lecture, and you want to be able to take notes on the slides that the lecturer is putting up in PowerPoint. So what I can do now is I have downloaded my lecture slides and I've put those in Dropbox. I click on here. And now I am able to flip through every one of the slides. And so I can go in and let's say the lecturer mentions something about this little area here. I can annotate right on this and write notes to myself. If maybe they're up on the chalkboard and drawing a diagram, I can come in and just put that in myself, and suddenly that's on my slide. And what I also like to do is sometimes there might be a picture in the lecture slides that I think will be useful to be able to better understand the syllabus. And so it's easier to have things in the same place. So what I can do now is I can use my tablet's copy function. So I'm going to select this little picture of our embryo. Cut that out. And now, if I wanted, I could save it to Google Drive or email it to myself. In this case, I'm just going to save it to my tablet's gallery. So now I realized, okay, that slide just answered the question that I had before from my syllabus. What is the foregut? So now I can click on this little picture here, the mountain icon, and I had that little thing saved to my gallery. Go to my screenshots, select that picture, and now I can resize it. There we go. Accept those changes. Now I can move my picture in. I can resize it here. I can click off there to accept it. And now I can see the foregut. It's this guy right here. So now this is basically just like this picture is copied into your PDF and you can draw on top of it like it was just included in the first place. We're very happy now. All right. So this is a particularly useful tool. You can take a screenshot or save images from the internet, from if you have like maybe a textbook online or something, and you want to be able to annotate directly onto it. This makes it so that you can basically have everything at your fingertips without having to carry around binders, notebooks, textbooks. And it's especially useful since we're talking about histology right now, to be able to go into the virtual microscopy program that BU uses, which is BioLucida, and be able to take screenshots of the slides and be able to annotate them right there and then. You can take a screenshot, save into Dropbox, and just do like we did here, click on the little image and go into Dropbox and be able to find your slide, annotate it, and be able to have it on your tablet and saved onto the cloud. You can also use your annotations to create flashcards using Anki, a program that we also have a tutorial on this site. And now, just gonna quickly show you what it looks like when you open it up, one of the PDFs that you've annotated on your computer. So I've opened up Dropbox on my computer, and now let's say that I wanted to look at the syllabus that I annotated. So this was my syllabus right here. Can open that up. And now you can see that this is basically exactly like I had it on my tablet. So I have my highlighted region, I have my picture with my little smiley face embryo, I have my lovely handwriting, and now I can access this annotated document from anywhere where I have internet access, or I can download it onto my computer, onto my phone, onto any device where I'd want to be able to access it. And this just allows you to be able to take your studying anywhere and not have to carry around pages and pages of notebooks and textbooks and be able to make the most of your paperless studying. I hope this tutorial was useful, and I hope that you are able to use Papyrus to enhance your studying experience.